I've been accused of cussing out my students, and I don't do that. I see, I just gave criticism to Dina Flockus over here, and I was very kind and let her know how stupid and foolish she was. Without saying anything to her. You know, the only thing that bothers me when I see all you kids here really busting your ass to try to make it in the business and really working hard to have some stupid thing like not having a job so that you can move down to Hollywood, not having enough money to pay your tuition, wanting to run off to New York for what? If man doesn't come from New York, what does he want to run to New York? There's no acting in New York. People from New York are coming out of here. Sean? And if you're not a New Yorker, you're in a foreign country. And the hell are you going to get on the off-Broadway or off-off-Broadway if you don't speak the Bronx? Okay. But you know, let me tell you something. If you want something, you're going to get it. I don't give a fuck what it is, all right? If you want to get it, you're going to get it. Go to work. Get a job. Move. You can't do anything without the money. So now, the point I'm trying to say is you can't lay back and do nothing. You got to get off your asses and you got to go to work. You got to afford your hobby. And it's a hobby until you're working professionally. Then it becomes a profession. Until that time, it's a hobby. Okay? And you got to support your hobby. The fishies die if you don't feed them, okay? The plants die if you don't water them. It's up to you. You want to get off your asses and work, you can.
Who am I anyway? Hi, I'm Paul Tarpey, and what you just saw was a glimpse into one of America's finest acting schools, the Van Maur Academy of Motion Picture and Television Acting. The white-haired conductor you saw, the guy that was kind of a cross between jolly old St. Nick and Captain Kangaroo, is none other than the incomparable Ivan Marcota, Mr. Van Maur himself. Let me take a moment and show you what Ivan's personally done for me. Come on inside. Let me take you upstairs and show you where I go when I first get my scripts. By the way, this room is all because of Ivan also. Come on upstairs with me and I'll show you. I lock myself in here for the first couple of days and just go over line after line until I get it down. And then I'm ready to shoot. This is the room where I take all the time to study when I get my scripts. One of the first things I do is get inside, get myself a drink. Notice I don't make any sound when I drop the ice into the glass. Another thing Ivan taught us. And then I grab my pencil, my script, and I get ready to break it down. All the things that Ivan taught us. And this is where I'll stay for 3-4 hours at a time sometimes, until I'm done. See you in a bit. After about 3 or 4 hours of studying, one of the last things I like to do before I go to bed is to turn on the jacuzzi and hop in for 20, 30, 40 minutes in 102 temperature and just kind of totally unwind. I find it very relaxing. I get a good night's sleep and I'm refreshed and feeling great at 4:30 in the morning when I'm off to work. Ivan helped me get all this and I thank him for it. It's my little retreat, my hideaway, my place of peace and quiet. I enjoy it a lot. Thanks, Ivan. I appreciate it. After a good night's rest, the first thing I do in the morning about 4:30 is get up and get on the Stairmaster and exercise for a good 20 or 30 minutes, and then I'm off to the studio. Kind of gets my energy going, wakes up all those blood cells, and I feel a lot better. And I owe this to Ivan, too. Thanks. And finally, this is the last part of my ritual. I fill up the tub with some hot water, get myself a bottle and a glass, fill it up with wine, have a little toast because the check's cleared. Good to be king. And I owe this all to you, Ivan. Here's to you. Okay, we're cutting out? Come on, we better get out of here. The homeowners are going to be home any second. Well, by now you're probably saying, who is this Ivan Marcota and how can he do this for me? Well, to many of us, he's that powerful-voiced acting coach.
There's a lot of bullshit in the business, but that's what this BS means. I'm going to teach you in this class what the BS is. Okay? Business sense, it's called, not bullshit. It's applicable to what? To attorneys, to doctors, to our politicians. Everybody uses BS. Business sense. Okay? What do you think the guy takes the manufacturer out to lunch over cocktails to sell something to him? He's not trying to be friendly. He's trying to sell something to him. That's our life. We have to do our thing.
Some of us who fall into that wanting to give it all up syndrome fondly refer to him as that good old kick in the ass, Ivan.
And to let him know that in our business it makes no difference what your nationality is. Okay? There's sexism, there's all kinds of things going on in Hollywood. If you let it bother you, it's going to bother you, it's going to restrict you. And if you don't, you know, fuck them. There is no race, there's no discrimination if you don't allow it to happen to you.
And yet to all of us, myself included, he'll always be Father Ivan. Well, Grandfather Ivan to me. Even though the father that you're accustomed to probably never talked to his kids quite like this.
It's not the way to do it. Steve, I envy you. No, it's okay. I'm not knocking you. I envy your wife. She gets to get pushed around all the fucking time. You don't do this. He got smart with me, and I beat the fuck out of him right there on my kitchen floor. Broke my table and broke three chairs and beat the shit out of him.
Oh.
And yeah, and then I grabbed him and I picked him up like this, and I really didn't hurt him bad because I got a punch that'll knock your teeth out. And I didn't do that. I just beat the fuck out of him and threw him and like, knocked down.
All with seven.
You're black.
I know.
Want to see your tan wine?
Yeah, I did. I got some this weekend.
You need to be blacker, right?
Hi, Chase. God love his gay ass.
Maybe he does.
Those lights have to go on.
That's quite the period, sir. What is that?
Send me two gourmet bottles of tequila. Like, I need that, right?
Right.
I'm on the wagon.
Yeah, what are you
doing? Give this to a kid.
I want you to know that when Therese there, who's Chuck's sister and Tio's daughter, came to me one time, she said she was having an identity crisis. I don't see any crisis. I said, your fucking mustache is growing like it's supposed to. I said, how's your dick? She said, well, I don't know. I didn't check it later. I said, you better check it. I bet it's growing. So next week, I bought her a dildo. And it's something she's got.
I cut in half.
Or did he? Nevertheless, I'm proud to be one of the instructors down at the Van Moore Academy. Ivan prepared me for that. When he was my acting coach, I learned from this larger-than-life man, who was also an accomplished actor himself, that he was gifted with what we like to call the perfect eye.
What are you looking at?
Behind those glittering blue eyes is a well-tuned mechanism that has become the actor's best friend. The eyes study every single nuance, and immediately it determines its authenticity. He happens to have the best eyes in the coaching business. You can't hide from them. And the serious actor wouldn't want to. And then ultimately, it pays off.